How we insulate for a more comfortable home. I'm Nick Schiffer. I own a custom home building company here in Boston, Massachusetts called NS Builders. And today we're at our Echo Pond project, a custom ground up new home that we're building for a client of ours. And I want to talk about our interior cavity insulation, which is a Rockwool comfort bat, our smart vapor retarder, which is the INTELLO Plus, and then how we're dealing with all the penetrations that pass through that system. So let's start by talking about the wall type. Typical for us, especially in the Northeast, we frame everything with wood construction, a 2x material, 16 inches on center. In this case, we have a 2x10 wall. Now, questions are gonna come up, why is it not a 2x4 or 2x6, not a 2x8? Why is it 2x10? Mainly for the thermal performance of the wall. We wanna have extra insulation. By adding extra insulation, we're able to reduce the heating and cooling requirements for the building. But also it's from an architectural standpoint. So we have some of these walls that are ultra thick to allow for our exterior pocket doors to slide into. So those walls fatten up accordingly. But looking at this one specifically, you can see that we have the backside of our sheathing beyond here. And then on the outside of that, we did another video on the exterior insulation. So we actually have 3.5 inches of insulation outboard of that. But in this cavity, we're actually using 2 layers of the comfort bat, and that's gonna give us that 9.5 inches of depth for that insulation. Now, one of the benefits of doing it in 2 pieces is that when you do have things like plumbing or electrical, you can actually install 1 layer behind those things and then put that 2nd layer on top of it. Now, in terms of the product, it's a Rockwool comfort bat. So we're using that for the thermal performance in the cavity insulation. When I say cavity insulation, I mean in between the 2 studs. Technically, you have this wood stud that goes all the way to the exterior. In most homes, they're built, and then you have cold air hitting the outside of that sheathing or that siding. That's really why we have that exterior insulation on this home. This bat insulation also is a great soundproofing material. So in this space over here, this is actually gonna be a future bathroom. So we'll actually fill all of our cavities around rooms that we want to create sound deadening with the Rockwool comfort bat. Same thing with the floor above. So we have bedrooms above this space. This is gonna be a workshop. So we want that separation from sound. So if someone is working down here and happens to be sleeping upstairs, we're adding that protection layer of sound deadening. Now, when we're doing a ceiling like this, what we'll typically do is we'll install a bat insulation and leave an air gap. It's just a typical detail for us. We find that by leaving that air gap above the insulation, we feel as though it does a better job of deadening the sound in between the floors. And how we typically will use a Rockwool comfort bat mineral wool insulation over, say, a spray foam or even a fiberglass product. And that's really driven by a handful of decisions. One of them being we find that this is a healthier product, not only in the way it's manufactured, but in the way it's installed and ultimately in the way that it lives its life. It also is a soft product. So when it fits into that cavity, it's pretty stable. It doesn't deteriorate over time, doesn't have the opportunity to shrink. And also spray foam is a chemical reaction that is very specific in terms of the environment that it gets installed. So there's a lot of decisions and a lot of parameters to install that correctly. So we choose to not use that. Despite having a higher R value, we're achieving those R values and even exceeding the R values that you might see with something like a spray foam by working through a detail like exterior insulation. We're choosing to use this ultimately for a handful of those reasons, but primarily driven by the health. So this goes into our cavity in those 2 layers. And then what we have is this INTELLO Plus, and this is a smart vapor retarder. What we're doing here is we're installing this across the entire wall, and you can see that it's stapled to the studs, but it's also taped at all of the seams. And it's really this kind of synthetic product. You can see closely the webbing of it. And the reason it's called a smart membrane is because it actually allows vapor to go through the membrane over, you know, say a polyplastic or something like that, that is going to trap vapor. This is actually going to allow vapor to pass through it depending on what's going on both sides of the wall. But ultimately it allows the wall cavity to dry, and that's the most important part. When we are dealing with exterior insulation, we're actually moving that condensing surface outside of the house. When you're reducing that exterior insulation, or if you don't have it, that cold and warm air are going to hit a point inside that wall cavity that can create moisture, and you want that moisture to be able to escape that wall cavity, and using something like this is going to help do that. Ultimately, when we're building a home, we have to think about the way in which these walls perform, but also over the time, or over time of someone living here, what's going to happen to this wall? Are people going to change things on the outside or the inside? And we want to do our best to make a really robust system, which is from this control layer all the way to the outside, because we want that wall to be long lasting. We don't want to be trapping moisture inside that wall, which can result to poor indoor air quality due to mold and mildew and things like that. We want to make sure that we're doing everything to prevent that. So by adding the exterior insulation and this vapor control layer on the inside, we're doing exactly that. What happens if they renovate the home and they open this wall up and they cut it, or they put a picture on the wall and they puncture it? You're ultimately damaging that control layer, which is why it's really important to have both the exterior insulation and this vapor control layer. Same thing here, you have the tape going down, and this is taping all the way down to that bottom plate. And that bottom plate is then sealed to the concrete. So we actually have an acoustic sealant underneath the plate, as well as a gasket. We're getting that continuous control layer, because underneath this slab, we actually have a vapor barrier. And now the difference between vapor barrier and vapor retarder is the vapor barrier prevents vapor from going through it at all. That's a Stego 15 mil barrier. When we were framing, we wanted a continuous membrane up from underneath the slab, up the wall, over the roof, and back down. So when you're building, especially traditionally, you build the walls and you're putting your floor system on top of it. So during the frame stage, the guys were actually really specific about draping over the Intello Plus to the top plate of your first floor walls. So when we got onto the second floor, that membrane actually flapped over top of the subfloor and allowed us to tie into that. So there's a really good view in the living room here that shows how the Intello was installed during framing stage. So if you look up here, we actually have an LVL behind the 2x on the flat. But look all the way up to where that top plate was. They've actually flapped that membrane over the top of that top plate, and you can see it hanging here. The reason it's hanging here is that it will be tied into the future ceiling once that's insulated. You can actually see that on the second floor, but when this ceiling gets insulated with the Rockwool, if you look up higher, you see the two layers of Rockwool and then that Intello coming down. When they get to the bottom top plate here, that will get taped, and now you have that continuous layer. What it's actually called a red pen test, or the pen test. I think I made up the fact that it was red, but the pen test, and that pen test essentially says that you never lift your pen up for that control layer, meaning that underneath the slab, it's one layer, it ties into the wall, it ties into the roof, it goes back down the roof, ties into the wall and back under the slab. And by doing that, that gives you that continuous control layer around the entire structure, making sure that you're getting the control layer that you need for these type of wall details. Now back to penetrations. We have Romex coming out here. You can see it coming in a couple different areas. We have boxes down low. Sometimes we have ductwork leaving. Sometimes we have plumbing leaving the exterior wall. What's really going to be critical is that we don't just leave this as is. Before this membrane goes up, it's really important that, you know, our team will go through, our super will make sure that this wire is coming out exactly where it needs to. So what they'll do is they'll end up taking a piece of tape, fold this in half, and they'll put it on the top, and then stick it here, and then they'll essentially cut and fold that down, and they'll do the same thing on the bottom, come underneath it, tape that, and flop up. And now what you're doing is you're creating a seal there. Again, you want to do your best to make sure that, you know, you're sealing each of these individually. You know, here you have two coming through. Ideally, you separate those and you seal them separately. Again, that is to get the ultimate seal around them. We want to do our best to make sure that every single penetration is sealed, again, for the best practice, despite this being kind of our secondary redundant layer for vapor control. We're outside in the breezeway here, and above me are these recessed lights. But above that is actually our living space. It's one of the bedrooms on the second floor of this home. We'll actually insulate all of these cavities, and then we'll install full plywood with a WRB, which is going to be our control layer. Even though it's not going to see bulk water, you are outside. But these lights really pose a big concern. And ultimately what you're looking at is we took some Zip R, which is an insulated sheathing material, and we created these air sealed boxes to house the recessed lighting. And then we just came in with a 3/8 hole and brought that Romex into that box. And then we air sealed the Romex coming in. And what that's doing is it's allowing the light to be really outside of our envelope and then have everything around that to be fully insulated. But more importantly, the air tightness. So as someone is standing across that second floor, this would be a really cold zone if we weren't managing air control, but also thermal performance. That is how we're managing insulation and how we're insulating to build more comfortable homes. You can see that there are some redundancies, but by spending more on insulation, we're oftentimes spending less on things like HVAC equipment because we're actually managing the comfortability inside that home a lot better. And we don't have these wild swings in temperature, even in the coldest of days.